Please, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you for this opportunity given to me to speak today. My name is Basant Kuswaha. I am representing a Madhesi community from Nepal. Actually, last month, on 16th October, my country, Nepal, was elected to the Human Rights Council by the UN General Assembly to a 3-year term beginning 1st January 2018. Nepal has been elected as a member for the first time in the UN body responsible for the promotion and protection of all human rights around the globe. And it is the matter of honor for us. But the question is, how can a government that does not care about protecting human rights and ensuring justice for its own citizens care about protecting the human rights of others? With the end of civil war in 2006, Nepalese government targeted youths of Madhesi and other minority communities demanding their rights in the upcoming constitution and killed hundreds of them. Dozens of cases of extrajudicial killings of the Madhesi youths were investigated and reported by even OHCHR in 2010. As a result, the Nepalese government forced to close OHCHR office in Madhesh and refused to extend the mandate of the United Nations mission in Nepal in 2011. With only the government's torture and no opportunities left behind and no one to even watch, millions of youths have been forced to leave the country to work mainly as laborers in the Gulf East countries in equally distressing conditions. Today, more than 4 million, mostly youths, have migrated out of Nepal. That makes one-third of total workforce of the country. I would like to take one example of Dr. C.K. Raut, who is an activist in Madhesh. He has been arrested for more than 15 times, jailed for several months, most of the time placed under house arrest. His books, videos, and websites have been banned by the government of Nepal. Thousands of his supporters have been arrested, hundreds of fake cases have been filed against them, and more than 100 people have been badly injured from the government's use of excessive force on peaceful mass assemblies. No media and no local human rights bodies are allowed to speak about them, and no programs, as they too are targeted by the government for covering any news related to them. International human rights organizations, including Amnesty International, Human Rights Watch, and Human Rights Commission, have repeatedly appealed to the Nepalese government to ensure Dr. Raut's freedom of expression and rights to peaceful assembly, demanding his release as well as droppings of all the charges filed against him. But the Nepalese government, in the lack of enough international pressure and strict measures against impunity, has not listened to them and continued violent, brutal suppression of youths and activities in Nepal. Only in the peaceful protest against the promulgation of Nepalese discriminatory constitution in 2015, which Madhesis have rejected, the Nepalese government killed more than 60 people. Even this week, 10 of Dr. Raut's supporters have been arrested by Nepalese police from peaceful rallies marking Anti-Racism Day on 26th November, just 3 days before, for advocating for right to reject in the upcoming election. Nepal has been a signatory to 24 international human rights-related conventions and treaties, including those related to civil and political rights, economic, social, and cultural rights, rights of the child, rights of the person with disabilities, and elimination of discrimination against women, the elimination of racial discrimination and against torture. Therefore, the United Nations and the national community should come forward strongly to protect freedom of expression, movement, and peaceful assembly, and to stop brutal suppression of the Madhesi and other minority communities in Nepal from the state and its agencies. To make a conducive environment for youths to live and work in their own homeland with a sense of security and dignity. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I now go to Francisca Tovar, Institute of Afro-Diasporic Studies, to be followed by Patrick Turan of the Global Migration Policy Associates.
Can you hear me? Hello. Thank you, Madam Chair, the committee. I'm the director and founder of an institution of NDO, which is Venezuelan, and has been following the crisis in my country.